Pieces as small as like a chip of paint, when they were flying the space shuttle, they returned to the Earth once with a big gouge in the windscreen. And that was caused by a fleck of paint. So even the smallest bits of debris can be a real problem. And the fact that we don't know about the millions of pieces of small debris, that's a concern. If you want to remove space debris that's uncontrolled, you can't send a signal to it because it's gone dark, you have to go and collect it. And you can't run a garbage truck in space if you can't refuel it. You end up collecting one or two pieces of debris, and then you have to throw away the garbage truck, or otherwise it will become debris itself. I was asking friends, just what is it worth if I could get you fuel in orbit? And I was absolutely shocked. The answer was $1 million of extra revenue for every kilogram of fuel. I'd never heard of anything like that. Right? I can buy that fuel for $300 a kilogram. And it creates $1 million per kilogram of value if I deliver it in orbit. From an economics perspective, just from extending life of these assets, it makes a lot of sense. But we realized very quickly the main value we're bringing is to enable business models that weren't possible before. Ultimately, our goal is to build not just a fuel supply chain, but an industrial chemical supply chain. We want to be able to provide air, water, 3D printer feedstock, fuel, lubricants, but any industrial chemicals for manufacturing in space, anything like that. Thank you.
So we're able to rely on communications and computing today due to encryption. One of the things that these new quantum computers are going to be able to do is break that encryption. It's very different than what we've all learned when we were growing up. And so something can't be in two places at once. It can't be multiple things at the same time. There can't be these multiple realities. And yet within quantum information science, that has proven to be true. It can be. A quantum computer can solve certain problems all at once by using quantum physics. We're going to be asking it questions not like, how fast is this? Can we watch Netflix faster? This is really about asking new kinds of questions. You know, what is the origin of the universe? Where did humanity come from? What's next? You know, how do we solve great problems of the world? With all new technologies, it's important to look at how it can be used for us to help humanity, and also how it might be used adversarially to hurt us. How do we protect our current digital infrastructures that run the world, that we use to drive our cars and to tell the time and to talk to our families? All of that uses a digital infrastructure. And all that is built on this concept of encryption. The reason you need to do that is because not only do you have to change what's in your world, you know, it's in your enterprise, but you also have all these other companies. Everybody's interconnected now. It's not a castle and a moat anymore. It's in everything. It's in the cameras. It's in our phones. It's in our cars. It's in our computers. It's in our communication systems. Everything we do, we communicate with encryption. And so when we do the discovery process and we walk our organizations through that, we're finding, you know, a lot of places that they had forgotten about. We're not changing the old vulnerable encryption to the single new post-quantum encryption algorithm. We're actually changing it to one of many that you use this one for downloading your movies, you use this one for high-speed trading, you use this one for phones and mobility. So you're going to need different ones, and then different countries are creating their own libraries of these new post-quantum algorithms. That's the worst case scenario, is people ignoring the problem until that headline happens that says, hey, you know, your biggest adversary can somehow turn all your machines off, turn all your communications against you, shut down whole parts of your economy. That's the level of risk that we're facing if we don't take these precautions, but the precautions are cheap and easy.